Moin, willkommen bei Glift. Ich bin dann eure letztebrechen Spruchecoach von glift.lu. Heute ist Woche Lektion Nummer 4 von Leia Letzebrech Seher mit Kurzlektionen. Hi and welcome to Glift. I'm Anne, your Luxembourgish language coach from glift.lu. This is lesson number 4 of my course Learn Luxembourgish Fast with Short Lessons. In today's lesson, you will learn how to use correctly the preposition an in Luxembourgish. So, let's start. So, lass. The preposition an has several meanings in English. It can mean to, in, or at. The meaning depends on whether there is a movement or not. An is a two-way preposition, meaning that you must pay attention whether there is a movement or not in the sentence. If there is a movement towards something or to a specific place, then you usually use verbs like gehen, fahren, kommen, flehen, klammen, stellen, lehen, machen, and so on. So these are all verbs expressing a movement. Let's learn some examples showing a motion with the preposition an. Example number one. Wir gehen an de Kino. Wir gehen an de Kino. We are going to the cinema. So there is a motion toward a destination. In this case, that's the cinema. Wir gehen an de Kino. Another example. Stellt Fleisch an de Frigo. Stellt Fleisch an de Frigo. Put the bottle in the fridge. Here we have as well a motion toward a destination. In this case, that's the fridge. Stellt Fleisch an de Frigo. Now, if there is no movement but the position, you use verbs like sind, wohnen, schaffen, stehen, leihen, essen, werden, and many others. So let's learn some examples showing a position with the preposition am. Example number one. Wir sind am or an dem Kino. We are at the cinema. So wir sind am Kino. So here we are already at a location, at a place, and not traveling somewhere. In this case, it's the cinema. Wir sind am Kino. Now, you can see that the definite masculine article den has changed to dem. We will see that later in this lesson. Another example. T'Fleisch steht am Frigo. T'Fleisch steht am Frigo. The bottle is in the fridge. So the bottle is already at its destination and not moving. So, when there is no motion in the sentence, the preposition an can contract. So an can contract with the definite articles, masculine and neutral, dem, and then it forms a contracted short form am. So when you have an dem, this contracts to am. Example, ich bin an dem Restaurant. We say ich bin am Restaurant. So the restaurant is masculine. Okay. So if the object that follows the preposition an is feminine, like Vacanz or Kantin, there is no contraction. The definite feminine article changes to da in the dative case. For example, ich essen an der Kantin. Ich sin an der Famil. So, let's move on. When do we use the preposition an? First, an plus land. So land is a country. So whether you are in a country, so a location, or you go to a country, so there's a movement, you use the preposition an. Examples. Ich gehe an Italien an Vakanz. Ich gehe an Italien an die Vakanz. So hier ist ein Movement. I go to Italy on holidays. Meine Eltern wohnen an Italien. Meine Eltern wohnen an Italien. So here is a location. My parents live in Italy, but we still use the preposition an. Watch out. There is an exception with Lützeburg. Lützeburg meaning here the country. Ich gehe am Sommer ob Lützeburg. So here is a motion. Then you say ob Lützeburg. Ich gehe am Sommer ob Lützeburg. And when you have a position, when you live in Luxembourg, you must say, ich wohne zu Lützeburg. So, we use as well the preposition an plus a Gebäude. A Gebäude is a building or in a place. A building can be the restaurant, the kino, tram, Taus, Philharmonie, den Theater, der Supermarché, Spidol, Chol, de Boutique, zum Beispiel den Zeitungsboutique, de Blumenboutique, and many others. In a place can be a lot of places. I have listed some common ones. De Frigo, den Tiran, de Schaf, de Köst, de Kitchen, but also de Busch. So we say, ich gehe an de Busch. Oder ich gehe an de Park. Ich gehe an de Gart. So this is really, this list is not exhaustive, but these places are very common and often used with an. Examples. Samstes gehe ich immer an de Restaurant essen. Samstes gehe ich immer an de Restaurant essen. There's a motion. Ich esse immer ein Dessert am Restaurant. Ich esse immer ein Dessert am Restaurant. So am here is the contracted form from an dem. Okay, we have seen that before in the lesson. When an is translated by during or in, so at the later time from now, then it is always followed by the dative case. Examples. An der Vakanz spielen kann er oft draußen Fußball. So during the holidays, the children often play outside. So an der Vakanz, and you see, you have to say an der Vakanz and not an der Vakanz, because it's the dative case. An der Vakanz spielen kann er oft draußen. Another example. Ich fuhre an 3D mam Zug ob Paris. Ich fuhre an 3D mam Zug ob Paris. This means that I go in 3 days by train to Paris. The last example. Wir treffen uns an einer Stunde auf der Gare. Wir treffen uns an einer Stunde auf der Gare. So we will meet later on or in an hour at the station. So if you don't remember how to use the verb treffen, I highly recommend to listen to lesson 1 of Learn Luxembourgish Fast with Short Lessons, which you can find on my blog. So, there you go for today's lesson. This is of course not the exhaustive usage of the preposition an, but these are the most common and examples when an is used. So, if you like this lesson, then you may consider taking my online course Lützebäisch am Alltag, Lauschte a Schwätz. If you want to understand conversations better, learn the expressions native Luxembourgish speakers use and speak more fluently, then this course is for you. This course has more advanced conversations that are full of common informal expressions used by native Luxembourgish speakers. It teaches you the phrases in context so that you will be able to remember and use them and become more fluent as a result. So click on the link below in the lessons description, Lützebäisch am Alltag, and get a free sample lesson from my online course. So talk to you in lesson number 5.